think that I have always been fascinated by a very simple and profound philosophical question is, why do people become who they are? You know, who are we? What are we? And questions of identity are central to that. And over the years, I've now written a number of books. This central question, I think, keeps coming back. And I have done, you know, more and more reading, more and more work, read more philosophy, read more biology. And I don't think this is a fully solved question. And in some way, fiction is the best arena to talk about the particularity of, you know, the human voice, the story of an individual person. And so I think I keep going over this area, and it will probably never be finished in some sense. This is an interesting question about age, because I'm now 56 years old, and I don't think that I would have tackled a book with these generations, in some sense, when I was younger. You know, young people are different. My first novel was about a young woman living in New York City, trying on various identities. But I now have a 23-year-old daughter. My mother is 89 years old. No, she's 88, pardon me. I don't want to age her before her time. She's living in 88. My father is dead. And I think that I have a somewhat broader view of the generations. And so the heroine of my most recent book, The Summer Without Men, it is a book where there are men, but the men are not on the scene of the book. They appear as memories, as emails, as ideas, but they're not active on the scene of, they're not in the action of the plot of the novel, and that's how I wanted it. So the main characters are all women, old women, a middle-aged narrator about my age, 55, and then a group of adolescent, pre-adolescent girls, a very little girl, 3 years old, and one baby who's a boy, but he's not pre-human, he's very human, but he's not a conversationalist yet. He's just a few weeks old. So I think that with age, I've begun to look across the human spectrum more fully, perhaps, than I used to. Now, I am deeply interested in psychiatry, psychoanalysis, neurobiology, all of this material that is, let's face it, part of the answer. You know, how do we become who we are? And I do think that the drama of psychiatric illness is some mysterious combination that really can't be separated between genetic temperament and personal story. So I gave my heroine brief psychotic disorder, a nervous breakdown essentially, but with psychotic features. Which means she hears voices, she's deluded, she really has a psychotic episode. For 2.5 years, I was a volunteer writing teacher at a psychiatric clinic in New York for psychiatric inpatients. Once a week, I would go and give a workshop. We would read poems, and I would have the students in my class, all psychiatric patients with various illnesses, respond to the poem in writing. It was a fantastic and remarkable experience for me. So for 2.5 years, I was very close teaching psychiatric patients, a number of them who were psychotic. They were all, taken medicine, of course, but nevertheless, the psychosis was present and present in their writing. I don't think I would have given my heroine a psychotic breakdown if I hadn't felt so close to some of these people who were experiencing psychosis. The reason that I gave her this diagnosis is because you can get over it. In other words, it is often happens when some huge shock or event has taken place in a person's life, it is possible to just disintegrate, have a psychotic breakdown, but never have another one. So the idea is that she recovers. And the book, in some way, is the story of her recovery, not the story of her illness, because most of the action takes place after she's out of the hospital and she's visiting her mother. I'm very glad you mentioned this, because actually I've found since the book came out, a lot of people, you know, they read the book and they don't mention these strange little drawings in the book. Now, I felt that this book called for those four pictures. They are not really illustrations. I think of them as little representations of the movement of the book. And if you look at the drawings closely, you will see they all involve a box. So in the first drawing, there's a person inside a box. And slowly in the second one, she's emerging from out of the box, looking outside. And then there's a third drawing that's quite peculiar, where a more realistic looking figure is speaking to a tiny little naked woman who's on the box. And at the end, there's a woman floating up and outside of this box. I had a lot of fun making those drawings, and I do draw, not in a deeply serious way, as you can tell from the drawings, but they became part of the feeling of the book, and I wanted them to have a comic sensibility, which I think they do. The book is a comedy. There are very serious things in it, but it has the promise of a positive ending in some sense. So the book is a comedy, and the way Shakespeare's plays are comedies. They can be very serious in the middle, but they end well.